Yo, what it is, man? What's up, boy? You know what it is, man. Friday, man. It's Good Friday, man. I've been saying I was gonna do this all-inclusive review, so I'm gonna go ahead and get to that today, man. I got a few pickups actually today, and most of the rest of this stuff is just stuff I have not got around to reviewing yet. So if you're wondering where the glasses went, yeah, the boy got contacts in, so you might see me blinking a lot because my eyes kind of dry. Anyway, let's get into it because I got a lot of things to do today, so. You know, it's a little spring cleaning going on, so you know, this closet will hopefully be straightened up the next time I do a video. Check. Okay, so these, I actually picked these up a little bit ago, man. I picked these up mid-February, I think. I never reviewed them though. Hey man, I've worn them a couple times. These are some great shoes, man. Asics, man. You know what I'm saying? Check this out, man. You know what I'm saying? Because I do run, you know what I'm saying? I do like to run, try to get active. So these are cool, man. I got these for stupid cheap up at Kohl's, man. I don't know if y'all mess with Asics or if y'all care about them, but I figured, you know what, maybe there's somebody out there that's a runner too. I want to check these out. I mean, they don't have any more. I checked online. They don't have this particular style, but you gotta watch Kohl's, man, because they do have some great shoe sales sometimes. That's one shoe. So we just gonna keep it moving, right? All right. This next shoe, this next set right here. I was pretty happy to see this, man. I went in the Foot Locker and I was like, okay, you know what I'm saying? I was putting my ticket in to get the Bred 11s. I was putting my ticket in. Of course, I didn't get the car, but I did get them. And then I saw these on the walls. I was like, man, I'm not gonna leave the store empty-handed. So, without further ado, you know what I'm saying? Boy got the Puma Sky Highs. Sky High! Yeah, boy. So, you know, had to do it with the Royal and Blue, man. And y'all gonna see something that kind of matches this a little later in the video that I'm probably gonna rock together because you know blue is my favorite color. These I thought were beautiful, man. $39.99, bro. I was like, hey, gotta have them, bro. So went ahead and went ham. Got kind of like the suede, you know what I'm saying, on the toe box right here. Got a little leather thrown in there, but it's mostly suede. You got your classic straps. You know, Puma boy at the top. You know what I'm saying? I don't only rock Jordans and Nikes. I do rock Pumas. I do rock Adidas. So, you know, and Asics too. So, you know what I'm saying? I always love these. I have a pair. It's kind of a throwback pair. I'll preview them real quick. You know what? I can't really get to them, man, because, you know, my closet's kind of a mess. But another day, I will check. I will show y'all. I have another pair that I at first, my first pair of Skies I got. Along with that being that day, since I was trying to, you know, I was trying to make up for not being able to get them Jordans that day. Of course, I got another way. My man's at the Foot Locker was like, "Hey man, these aren't out there on the wall, but these are some exclusives. Hey, $39.99. They probably not that exclusive, but look, man, these are tough, man. I'm rocking these back to the city, man. I just haven't even put them on yet. I haven't even tried them on yet. Going back to the city of St. Louis to some Cardinals games." Yeah, these boys coming out, man. So, like I said, $39.99. Beautiful shoe, in my opinion. Love high tops, man. I love mid and high tops. Don't really rock low tops too much. But these right here, man, had to have them. They're classics, man. One of the first Pumas I ever donned. So, yeah, I was happy to get two more pair of them. And these will be coming out this weekend. So, I'm going to take some pictures, man. I'm going to put them up on Instagram and Twitter so y'all can see how they look on the feet. But same thing, suede on the toe box, a little bit of leather thrown in there. Leather with the Puma here, which is actually a little different from the other one because I don't think the other one's actually leather. I think it's suede. So kind of cool, a little different variation there. All right. And again, I got these, man. I got these a minute ago, man. I just kept on meaning to review them. I just didn't get to. So y'all saw I had those KD5s last time. Welp. I told you I had two more pair, right? So these are the ones I've actually rocked quite a bit, man. I hoop in these, man. These are my hooping boys, man. These are Hawk Green, man. I like to call them the Green Lantern Fives, man. And I got, man. And, you know, obviously you can tell I've been hooping in them. You know, I've rocked them. What rocked them last week and hooped up at Purdue, man. Shout out to Purdue, my, you know what I'm saying, my alma mater. Got the KD on there. Cool, cool. Because if you notice on these ones, they say KD on both of them. If the N7s, if you watch my last. Video, you saw N7 on one of them and then KD on the other one. So these are tough, man. Honestly, I wear them with ankle braces and everything. Comfortable as a mug, like, you know what I'm saying? I'm 6'1 and a half, but your boy can dunk. So I got to have a lightweight shoe that's going to, you know, protect my ankle. Beautiful, man. Still got your 3.5 on there. All of this is green, man. I don't even usually do green, but I love these, man. So that's, you know, that's these. And got these at, I picked these up at Finish Line. And these were 114.99, so 115 plus you had to pay the little tax. But those are cool. These I have put some pictures up on Twitter, but I still have not rocked them or donned them yet. These right here, if I can get the box out, check them out, boy. You know what I'm saying? These are the Bugs Bunny ones, man. Anybody that didn't get them, man, these are a great shoe, man. You might still be able to find them some places. As you can notice, I did the 8 review yesterday. You kind of got a similar theme there. It's supposed to look like the 8. It's basically like a Jordan 1 hybrid mixed with the 8. So you can see a lot of elements of that 8 on there. So you can see that like the back of that looks like the 8. You know what I'm saying? You still got your suede there. It's a leather toe box. You know what I'm saying? Got the 23 stitch there, which, you know, is not on a lot of the shoes anymore. So it is, I mean, I guess it is on the 8, but it's not stitched on. Anyway, so these, love them. Fresh, man. I like the inside little design there. Think it's fly as heck, man. These will be rocked. I don't know when, but I will keep y'all posted, man. And if you know the ones, you know what the bottom looks like. You know what I'm saying? Sorry, I'm kind of flying through this video, but you know, I'm going out of town today, so I gotta make sure I got everything in order. Make sure my dishes washed. So yeah, love these, man. Got those from NBA store. Picked those up for $130, no tax and free shipping. So NBA store, whenever they have releases, man. Hey, I'm gonna try to jump on them, man, because hey, that no tax free shipping sounds good to me. Sounds real good to me. And then as far as the shoes go, the last pair of sneaks I will debut. Easter boys, like I said, it's Good Friday. All month is Good Friday. All since last month, every Friday has been Good Friday. As you can see, I've already tried the shoe on. I have not rocked them yet, but I have tried them on because I know I'm rocking these. These are a 14, actually. My other KD5s that I have are both 13s, so I can hoop in both of those, but these will not be hooped in. They will be more like a rock shoe, just, you know what I'm saying, for me to, you know, stay fly, stay fresh, do what I do.
It's 1 o'clock.
Oh, it's 1 o'clock, yeah. You know, my computer is telling me all that kind of stuff. So yeah, you got your classic KD here, just like the other KD5s. Signature, you should be able to see that at the top of there. I love this mint green on the bottom, man. It's a beautiful colorway. The way that they blended this together, I think it's just magnificent, man. And then you kind of got like a, you know, I don't know what you want to call it, maybe like a graffiti or you know, like a paint splatter type thing they did for the check, which I think is super fly, man. You know what I'm saying? I wouldn't wear these to Easter on Sunday, but I think they are some fly ones. Still got your 35s. Those are fresh. These right here, man. They I got these from East Bay. I got them for retail. Yeah, $114.99, and I had to pay a little tax. Not tax, but a shipping charge. I think they stupid fly. I will be rocking them very soon. Just kind of waiting for this weather to clear up, man. Indiana is so flippant, man. We have flooding. We have snow. And then we have the sun. So it's hard for me to wear my new shoes. But anyway, these are super fly, man. Like I said, a 14. I didn't think I was going to be able to get them. But kind of got lucky. Lucked out on that. So really blessed to get those. Now, as far as what else I'm going to review, I do have a couple of items that I just got. Macy's.com. They had their friends and family sale going on. 25% off. Of, you know what I'm saying, of anything, pretty much anything except for like Gucci, which, come on, man, I don't make enough for Gucci yet. So you know your boy, I don't only do shoes, man. You know what I'm saying, I do have other interests. So hold on, can I get it straight? Yeah, here we go. So the boy got a couple G-Shocks, man. 25% off, man. You can't beat that when it comes to G-Shocks. Macy's has a crazy stock of G-Shocks, man. Crazy, man. Like, they have colorways that I've always wanted that I could never find. You know, I had to get it. When I saw that sale, you know, this was actually delivered in 2 days. I actually went to UPS today because I was like, look, I'm going out of town. I'm not trying to miss the UPS dude. So, comes with your little metal box. I will be getting more G-Shock, so I will be doing more reviews on these. These are my first two, technically. I had one And then I was like, nah, I don't want to keep it, so I returned it. I had bought that from Casio. So, first one I got, which I mentioned this early in the video, check it out, man. This one is the 8900. It's in the royal blue and black, which, come on now. How fresh is that together, man? Come on now. You know what I'm saying? How fly would this outfit look together, man? I'm going to set something up. I'm going to show y'all what I do with it. Retail 110. Like I said, 25% off. I think I got it for like 80, 82 or something. Something like that. It's got your little light there. If you can see it. I hope you can see it. You know, super fly, super fresh. You know what I'm saying? G-Shocks kind of go hand in hand with hip-hop. You know, sneakers. You know, I've always been interested in all of those. So, glad to finally put one of these on my wrist. I do have a Casio that I wear now, but it's no G-Shock. So, yeah, check it out, man. Trying to get without the glare. But if you can see this black, you know, the whole back of it is blue, which I think is super fly, man. Like I said, got that for a really good price. They still got that sale going on, I think, or maybe over now. May end it yesterday. You may want to just give it a double check, because you never know. Like I said, $82, I think, was what I got that for. Had to pay a little tax, free shipping, though, and it got here in 2 days. Crazy. Other one, this is the one I had in return, because I just couldn't hold on to it, because I was afraid, you know what I'm saying, I was spending too much at one time. This was my last semester of college when I bought this one, but I had to get it again. You know what I'm saying? $150 retail, as you can see on the little ticket here. $150 retail, but with that 25% off, man, that knocked a pretty good chunk off there. So this is like a gold and black deal. I think it's super fresh, man. Super fresh. As far as the light goes, it's in a little different of a spot. It doesn't have like a G-Shock button there. So I think it's got, hold on. So I had this before, but I don't really remember. Oh, there it is. Okay, so it's got a little light on the side, and then it kind of lights the corners up and stuff. Gold and black, super fly. Got it for a really good price. Of course, that's not real gold, but you know what I'm saying? It's pretty neat. It's got the hands on there. I don't know if you can see. You should be able to see the hands that it's got to tell the time, and then it also has a digital aspect to it. So I like that. And this one is, see the model number on this one is the GA110GB. So, and that's 1A. So that's that model number. They still have this on Casio.com. It's $150 retail, like I said. So when I saw a sale, I had to have it, had to get it. I think it's super fly. I love watches. There's a lot of smart watches and stuff that are coming out. So I like to match my watches up with, my sneakers, and anybody knows me knows I wanted those retro ones, black and gold. How fresh would this have been, you know, to rock those two together? Plus, you know what I'm saying, got my Purdue colors on, you know what I'm saying, boiler up, baby, because, you know, that's where I graduated from, baby, you know, shout out to my university. But yeah, man, I'm gonna wrap this up short and sweet, baby. I hope everybody caught everything I said, and if you didn't, you know what I'm saying, rewind, listen again. I'm going out of town for the weekend. Maybe next Friday I will have some other stuff to review, because I like to review on Fridays, because it seems like I always get my stuff delivered on Fridays or by Friday. So, like I said, it's just another good Friday. I'm staying blessed. I hope you guys are too. Like, subscribe, tell me what you think, tell me what you don't like, whatever it is, doesn't matter. And remember, stay fresh, stay fly, do what you do, and pay them bills before you buy stuff. You know what I mean? So, check. Y'all have a good weekend, man. Yeah, peace.